Hello, my fellow Earth Angels. Thank you so much for being here and joining me today. I'm really excited to share some of the very simple and daily practices that I do that make me feel so embodied and liberated from within. And I've mentioned this in the past, but sometimes we hurt because there's so much aching to be born through the surface that we have not yet made the space for, stories that haven't been processed, feelings that need to be felt. And we walk around feeling like these half humans and like we don't really even know who we are some days because we haven't sat with all of the things that want to come up. And so these embodiment practices can be done in 10 minutes throughout your day and can really establish you in the seat of who you are, in the witnessing of all the things that are coming up. I always feel so comfortable with myself after I've cried a little bit or after I've expressed a feeling or a boundary to someone I love. And that being said, the things in this video are really great to do with friends. I always end up doing these things with sisters. Like, we naturally just drop into this space and it's so wonderful to do with friends. So let's just get into it. I'm bleeding today. I'm feeling a little loopy, but I'm just sending you love. I hope you can feel the vibes. Give your body permission to express its full experience. All of our traumas and emotions tell a story through our body, and if we don't move the energy of grief, anger, jealousy, longing, or tension, it can create a permanent home inside of us. Daily movement really helps to prevent this. Identifying the feeling and dancing the dance of your own liberation is an immaculate healing and embodiment tool. What does your rage look like? What does joy look like in your body? Set it free. I like to begin with shaking my body, literally just shaking out tightness or density while sighing out loud and establishing myself in my breath. I do hip circles while touching my body, heart, and womb, exploring the way that it feels to be in this vessel. Sometimes I'll start real low to the ground and get primal with it, pushing against the earth, feeling the weight of my body pushing into the earth. And when I do this with my sisters, we will growl at each other and embody our wildness fully, crawling on all fours and just activating our primal essence within. Focus all of your awareness on how this movement feels inside of your body, not how it looks. Everything you do is right. All the space you take up is welcomed, and all that is asked of you is to feel deeply in this time. If you don't know how to dance or move, visualize an energy ball of light in between your hands and simply move it throughout your field. Bring this all together with your favorite songs or check out the playlist I made linked below. And just groove with it. Sometimes living your best life and healing can look cringy as heck, but that's a sacrifice I'm willing to make to feel good in my body and share it online. There is no stage, there's no one to really perform for. This is just a somatic healing practice, and you can let out that sacred rage with screaming or crying or laughter. And also doing this barefoot on the earth is extremely grounding. I wanted to guide you through one of my favorite breathwork practices that I always return to. It's extremely grounding and balancing to the nervous system. And on days where I just want to really feel fully embodied, I also love doing more intense Kundalini energizing breathwork practices. But when I was going through my depression and healing a lot of trauma and also struggling with disassociation, I noticed that those very energizing, fiery breathwork practices would blast me out of my body. I would feel so ungrounded. It would take me days to feel back in my vessel. So for that reason, I'm just going to share the more universally, I think, helpful breathwork practice, and I will leave more intense or fiery practices in the link in my bio, guided by other people, just so that you still have that resource if you want it. Bring your eyes to a close. Begin to establish yourself in three-part breathing, breathing into the tummy, the ribs, and the chest. Deep breath in, exhaling fully, navel pushes back to the spine, ribs come together and the chest gently lowers. Establishing yourself in the sensations of the breath. Bring your awareness to wherever you feel your breath most strongly. Maybe it's in the back of your throat as you inhale. Maybe it's by your upper lip as you exhale. Maybe it's in the rise and fall of your tummy. And I will begin guiding you into Savitri Pranayama. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold the breath in for 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold the breath out, 2, 3. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold in, 2, 3. Full exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold out, 2, 3. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold in, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold out, 2, 3. Full breath in, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold in, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold out, 2, 3. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold in, 2, 3. Full exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold out, 2, 3. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold in, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold out, 2, 3. Full breath in, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold in, 2, 3. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hold out, 2, 3. And you can continue on your own for as long as you wish. I like to do this practice for 15 minutes to half an hour, or even just 5 minutes in my day. For the sake of this video, I wanted to just give you a little taste. And you can find yourself back in normal rhythmic breathing. Even just a few moments of breath awareness can really calm your nervous system and shift your physiological state. And I have been loving vocal toning as well. It has become a habit that anytime before I hang out with anyone, and just daily, I use my voice, I tone, I just make noises, and I really get comfortable with the sound of my own voice, with making noise. And I really feel like it makes me feel so embodied and so confident when I do speak and my voice is loud and strong and coherent. So let's chant the vowels together. It looks a little something like this. Taking a deep breath in, tummy, ribs, and chest. Exhaling fully, maybe making a sound, and then we'll begin. Using the full length of the breath so that the inhale comes naturally. And you can do this in any tone or range that you would like. You can do this 3 rounds in a row. And then after, what I really love is just to tone and make different noises and just kind of harmonize with myself and the present moment. And that looks a little something like, and it doesn't have to sound good. It's really just to extend your exhale, establish yourself in your breath and in the sound of your voice. And I truly think that each person's individual voice and tonality is healing to their own nervous system. And for anyone who has given birth, you may know the experience of making sound actually eases the tension in your womb when you're having contractions. And I feel like when I'm bleeding, this really helps my womb as well to just feel less crampy, and it just opens everything up. When your jaw is tense, it's usually a sign that there's tension in other places in your body. This is Lily, in case I haven't really introduced my dogs I adopted through my partner. She's the cuddliest creature I've ever known besides myself. And mantras are protection for the mind. Mantra means mind tool in Sanskrit. And so if you are continually affirming something, praying something, or singing something, your mind will continue to return to that frequency and that place as your baseline rather than dense thoughts or heavy programming that you might be carrying. It's giving liberation, and that is the whole thing, and that's why we're here. I love spending time with my best friends every day, my best friends being the trees and all of the elements, just feeling the sensations of the wind on my skin and the plants against my fingertips. It is such a moving meditation. When you are in nature, you're literally surrounded by life, and everything around you, the plants, the trees, the grass, has an energy, a spirit that is being impacted by your presence, and you are also being impacted by the spirit and energy of the trees. And I love visualizing the life force energy just draping me as I walk through nature, just completely embracing me everywhere that I am. And genuinely, when I walk past trees, I just visualize its aura blessing me, and I visualize my aura and my presence blessing the trees in this energy exchange. And sometimes I will just stand by a tree and really like meditate and breathe with it, or I'll sit and I'll feel this energy exchange that's taking place. And my dad has a Qigong teacher. He one day asked my dad to call upon the energy of the lemon tree and to visualize the lemon tree in front of his house. And my dad tried to do it. He thought about the tree, and in about 10 minutes, the Qigong master had called upon the energy of the tree, and the whole living room smelled like lemons, even though the lemon tree was all the way outside. And it's just so powerful being able to tap into the energetic grid of life, and that's what I kind of carry with me when I walk through nature.
I also love to actively release any density from my body through the bottoms of my feet. So just taking a deep breath in and pushing and releasing down any heaviness into the earth, and then replacing it into all the major centers of your body with this life force energy that you feel in nature. And this is a form of Reiki that you can do on yourself, is just bringing that healing energy into your body and cleansing your auric field.
I'm ending my night with some cacao. I love adding cacao nibs or just a really raw cacao blend to a sweeter one. But I wanted to share some books that I feel like are great for embodiment. The first one is The Body Keeps the Score, and this one is so good. I highly recommend it. It's basically just about how trauma really affects us and can show up in different ways in our bodies, neuroplasticity, and how to actually let go of the past on a physical level. I haven't finished reading it, but it's so great. a pioneering researcher transforms our understanding of trauma and offers a bold new paradigm for healing. This next one, The Body Is Not an Apology by Sonia Renee Taylor. Sonia was on Brené Brown's podcast. I'll link that podcast down below. And this book is just really incredible. Even the title alone, The Body Is Not an Apology, is just such a mantra and such a statement and a belief system that hits so deep and that I want to call upon in all moments. And yeah, it's the power of a radical self-love. It has made me feel even more unapologetic about the way that I take up space and the way that my body looks. I used to apologize all the time for the smallest things, like, sorry, I look tired right now, or sorry, I forgot to shave, or sorry for just the random imperfections or straying from any form of conventional beauty in high school. And I just cannot believe how much I would excuse myself and my natural bodily functions. And I have definitely grown a lot from then. Like, I always grow out my hair pretty much on the regular. I am not worried about looking imperfect, having acne scars, having acne. I mean, obviously I show that all the time on here. Yet there is still programming that makes me feel small or that makes me want to hide certain little things. And this book is just really great. And then this last one is actually a fairy tale book that I got from the thrift store. It had the most beautiful illustrations. I'll show you some of them. And I have always loved reading fairy tales because it just makes my inner child feel so alive and opens me up to my imagination. The path of ascension requires you to really fine-tune everything that you're taking in through your senses. And so I would much rather read a fairy tale than watch a really violent show full of viral programming. It's not as fucked up as the world can be sometimes. And I also really like to light candles and pray. I have a lot of candles lit right now. I normally don't light like every single candle. And you can call upon anyone. You can call upon your angels, your ancestors, your family of light, your guides. If you don't know who your guides are, you can drop into a deep state of meditation and ask, who are my guides? Who is my family of light supporting me? Or I'll get really clear messages that feel divinely downloaded into my consciousness. And it sounds woo-woo and all that stuff, but I do think that there's some real aspect to channeling and just receiving downloads. And truly, it could just be from your higher self. It could be just a really good idea that you get from your mind finally being clear. And I think that when it comes to spirituality, there's always like a very woo-woo explanation to things. And there's always just like a grounded, very realistic version of like, well, when you're not thinking and bombarded from thoughts, sometimes the greatest ideas can come through in that space. And some people might be like, oh my God, I channeled this from the Arcturians and this is what's coming through. Or it can just be like, wow, I had this really good idea today. And both are so valid. I do think that things get lost in translation when you do try to label and define all of it. Yeah, these are just some of the things that I do to feel very embodied in my voice, in my journey, and that make me feel really grounded and also expansive and light and just full within myself. So I hope that you try some of these out. Thank you for spending time with me today. I cherish you so deeply, and I hope to see you in a video soon. Bye.